G'day mates, welcome to the Total War podcast. So this is a new mini-series while we're waiting for some more content to be released for Rome 2 to do some more podcasts. We do have another podcast scheduled with the Game Dudester, and we're going to be and some other of the Shogun competitive players. That will be up soon enough once we are able to record it. So this is a couple of interviews with your favourite Total War podcast members and people from the Total War community. So first off, we have Hesphaestion.
Mm-hmm. Hello guys, hello.
Alright, so let's kick this off. What was the initial thing that caused you to record and upload videos to YouTube?
Okay, so what made me want to start on YouTube pretty much?
Yeah.
Let's just say I liked making videos my whole life. I just like making videos, editing videos as well. If you guys know me, I like to edit videos and stuff, and I love the game Rome to the War, and I started watching Prince of Macedon. And I thought I could do that as well, so that's how I started. I was inspired by Prince of Macedon, and yeah, that's where it all started.
All right, cool. So basically, come to our next question. Where are you from? For some people who do know from your channel, you are from Australia, but you might have noticed you have an English accent, so just explain all that.
Yeah, just a little bit. Yeah, I was born in England, and I moved to Australia when I was 10. I've been here for about almost 8 years now, and I mean Australia now. I'm in Australia, New South Wales, same as you, mates.
Yep.
And yeah, that's pretty much it.
All right. So, have you found it hard at all, being from Australia, due to the collab times? You know, setting up different videos with other people.
Yeah, I think you would agree with me that just playing with games as well with people, like example, Mount and Blade and stuff. The ping is horrible. It's just you get this lag and it's horrible, but sometimes it's fine, and because most of our subs and stuff are like from America, Europe area, you know, time differences is really annoying. So it's pretty much opposite. So that's the only problem, because when I want to play games online and I want to play with my subs and they're all from like England or something, I have to like stay up to like 3 a.m. to play with them or something. You know, it's just annoying.
Yeah, we've both suffered to do the podcast. So
yeah, a perfect example would be the podcast. When we try and set up a podcast, it's always me and you waking up at 5 a.m. Everyone else is like in the afternoon.
All right.
Should be grateful.
So what's your favorite thing about uploading? About recording and uploading, really. Yeah.
Oh yeah. Well, recording's fun because you're playing your games and you're talking, or pretty much talking to yourself. And uploading, you get awesome feedback. You know, you get so many people from all over the world just saying nice things about you. You know, you get the occasional douchebag, but that's fine.
Yeah, there's always one.
It's always nice reading comments, people saying, oh, you're funny, you're awesome, your commentary's mad. It's just that kind of stuff that keeps on motivating me to, you know, to keep on doing what I do. And I think that's the same for most people, you could say.
Yeah, for sure. So how many videos have you actually uploaded?
247.
All right, not a bad number. Solid number
at this time, yes.
And how many subs are you sitting on currently?
Let me just check. 1256 at this time.
Going strong there. So we move on to, what type of videos are you looking to do in the future?
Total War. Nah. I don't know. I'm sort of, if people have looked at my channel, I've started to go onto different kind of games. But at the moment, it's just Total War, because everyone loves Total War. Who doesn't love Total War? Come on.
Sure, for sure. And we need to, what, so saying from that, what is your favorite Total War game?
Right now, I would say Medieval, because I've been playing Rome to the War since 2004. I still remember the first day I've got it. I've still got my first disc I got in 2004. And that game has been so nice to me. I've loved that game, every minute of it. I still love it, but Medieval is amazing because it's just, I don't know, even though it was made, was it in 2005? No.
I'm not too sure.
The game was made quite a while ago, and it's still, to me, amazing. The graphics are awesome. All the units stuff is awesome. So yeah, I would say Medieval Total War at the moment is my favorite Total War game.
Yeah, so Medieval Total War 2, right?
Oh yeah, of course. Sorry, I completely forgot that was the first.
All right. So I think most people that watch your channel would know what your favorite mod is, but just to clarify, what is your favorite Total War mod?
Easy peasy. Thalia's Total War, by far. Best mod ever.
A lot of people probably agree with you. Have you tried the Moss mod yourself? The sub mod for it?
Yes, that's a secret. Shh. Nah. Yeah, I will be doing a series on the Moss as well, actually.
Oh, actually I had a question for that. Well, there you go. So, you already said earlier that you were inspired by Prince of Macedon.
Mm-hmm.
Would you say he's your favourite commentator?
I love the guy to bits, because he's just Prince of Macedon, he's a legend. But there's different people who have inspired me. Prince of Macedon inspired me to start YouTube, and then there's other YouTubers who have inspired me to do different things, like Sapphire Phoenix. I think his channel is very professional, it's very well done, because Sapphire Phoenix was pretty much the next person I met, really, after Prince of Macedon. So, and then there's like tips from Cold Meat, you know, all the annotations, all the description links and stuff, and tags. That's from Cold Meat. And then there's other famous, millions, like Tom Syndicate, if you know him.
Yep.
He's just a hilarious commentator. He's full of energy all the time, and I'm inspired by him. And he's a good bloke.
So you'd say that you draw your inspirations from more than just the Total War community?
Oh yeah, of course.
Yep. Are there any other games that you would say that you play a lot as well, outside of the Total War?
Mountain Blade. Zulu.
Okay. So, keeping in thing with Total War and the games that you're playing and you enjoy, what is the biggest thing you are looking forward to in Rome Total War 2?
Ooh, that's a hard question. Well, of course, they're adding the naval and land battles in one. I think that's going to be awesome. I'm looking forward to that a lot. And from the recent
Battle of the Teutoburg Forest.
Yes, yeah. And we saw the flaming balls going down the hills. That's definitely going to be awesome as well. I'm going to have a lot of fun with that.
I'd just like to interject there quickly.
Oh, sorry, mate.
In a very recent video from Creative Assembly, they announced that you can use them 100%. Anyway, back to
Slicing. Yeah, I saw that, yes.
Alright, sorry about that. Interjection there. So.
It's cool.
Okay, so now we move on to just things general around your YouTube experience and everything. So how has it affected your life outside of YouTube?
It's made me stay indoors a lot more, for sure. But, it's all worth it. I've met so many awesome people as yourself, mates. I've met you, Snowed, Cold Meat, Sapphire Phoenix, Saxon King, all these awesome people I've met from YouTube. So that is, and you guys are pretty much, I would call, a good mates, you could say. You guys are my good mates, and that has definitely been worth, staying indoors a lot. But, you know what I mean?
Yeah, gotta find a good balance there.
Good balance.
So, before starting YouTube, what did you expect out of uploading the videos? So becoming a commentator online.
At the start, I didn't think I would get anywhere. I got my first 10 subs and I had a party. And that was awesome, because I pretty much just started off talking to people on Rome to the War online, saying, oh look, check out my channel. I'm like, oh, okay, cool. And then obviously I got a big help from Sapphire Phoenix, and then things started to change. But at the start, I definitely didn't think I would get anywhere. I didn't really think I would go far.
Yeah, that seems to be a general feeling a lot of the commentators do when they first start off. You just said that you didn't think you'd go anywhere. Obviously, your expectations were exceeded. You would say you grew a lot quicker. Do you reckon you'll meet your 2013 goals this year, like you did for 2012?
Yeah, I actually have. Actually, I've hit all my goals already.
Already? There you go.
Yeah, well, one of them was to get partnered with, I got partnered with Machinima quite recently. Hit 1,000 subs. I got that a few weeks ago. And, actually, no, wait, the third one isn't, actually. I just forgot. The third one is to get a good computer.
Soon enough, mate, soon enough.
Soon enough, yeah.
So, move on to the next question, which is, have you felt that you have created all, and you will leave a mark on the YouTube community, or the Total War community?
Ooh. I would like to. I'm not sure about that. I haven't thought about that, actually.
There you go. Good question to ponder on.
Yeah. It would be nice.
If the possibility arises, would you make YouTube your full-time income?
Yes.
Yep. Oh, yes. Very definite answer.
I loved what I'm doing, and I'm not making a lot at the moment, but if I could do this full-time, without a doubt, yes.
Yep.
Just talking to fans every day, making videos, entertaining people, I'll be sweet with that.
Awesome. I think a lot of your subscribers will be happy to hear that.
I'm staying around for a long time.
So another thing I personally, and I'm sure a lot of people would like to see, since it's not a topic that's brought up a lot, what's your personal and honest opinion about the Total War community in its current state?
Compared to other games, like example Minecraft, it's not very big. The Total War community is quite large, but compared to other games, it's not as large. But I'm hoping that when Rome 2 comes out, it will bring in a lot more new people to the Total War community. That's pretty much it.
What do you think about the general communication between the, you know, the varied commentators, the fans, and how do you think it will change as more people come in through the huge launch, which will be Rome Total War 2?
I'm not sure about that, mate.
There.
Yeah, I don't know. I can't think of anything to say for this one.
No problem. So we'll move on to the next one. Anything you have a problem with now, or anything you would like to change within the Total War community?
Get it bigger.
All right.
I think the Total War community at the moment is awesome. I think we've got some awesome people out there who enjoy all of our videos, and yeah, I'm pretty happy with it so far. But it'll be, you know, it's always nice to have more.
Yep, so we move on to general tips and stuff that you can give to the fans and people who are looking to start to YouTube and uploading. So, any tips that you would suggest to people?
I'll tell you what I did. Well, I think I said this before. I played a lot of online stuff. Tell people online to go check out your channel. That always helps. To start you off a little bit, and then, of course, you can agree with me, getting bigger YouTubers to help you out. Arcanet is the best way these days. Like, Sapphire Phoenix helped me. I think Sapphire Phoenix helped you a bit as well, didn't he?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. For sure. but you can't be annoying. You can't be like, oh, give me a shout out. You've got to, like, maybe, you know, how about we play a game together? You know, maybe you could help my YouTube out. It depends how much effort you want to put into your channel. That makes YouTubers like us, sorry, to help out small YouTubers. If they're willing to put the effort in,
for sure.
And yeah, I'm always happy to help out someone. As long as they put the effort in, they deserve it.
For sure. So, just putting out there something as well for people who are looking to start out. Like what Tom said, don't be afraid to contact the people. Don't be annoying, of course, like he said.
But we're not scary.
Yeah. That's one thing that people seem to be a bit afraid about, is contacting the other YouTubers. Don't spam them, but show that you're putting in the effort. Anyway, this is about Tom, so we'll carry on here.
Yeah, Wallmarkers is a bit scary, so don't make that. I'm kidding. No, we're all friendly. It's just that some of the bigger YouTubers, you know, they get it a lot. So maybe if you're starting, recommend talking to smaller people like us. We always have time to give shout-outs and stuff.
Yeah,
most of the time. So you can give it a try. But some of the bigger YouTubers, they get thousands of messages a day. So.
Yeah, you have to remind yourself of that. So, what challenges have you personally run into while uploading and becoming a bigger director on YouTube?
Challenges.
So, either computer-wise or internet-wise, or just in terms of time constraints to do sports or anything you do outside. So, yeah, just a general.
Well, for a long time before I was partnered, uploading videos was quite a pain. Sometimes I was staying up really late. That was really annoying. And, you know, especially when I have school still, you know, there's a lot of staying up just to upload a video. And sometimes I thought, is this even worth it? And a lot of times, like, I didn't upload videos for days because of that. But, good internet helps. My internet's all right at the moment. But and also, for most of you who know, I'm still on a laptop. Recording games can get quite painful. Yeah, that's pretty much it.
All right. So last And final question for your subscribers, anyone that is interested in your channel, which the link will be down there in the description.
Ooh.
Any sneak peek as to info on any new series coming to your channel, which I think you might have mentioned before?
Yeah, if you've been here since the beginning, then I sort of mentioned that I've got the Moss mod for Third Age Total War, and I'll be starting a series that no one's done before on that, so yeah, be prepared.
What could that be?
I'm not doing a faction vote because I just like to do stuff that I like to do, pretty much.
I'm kind of trying to think now what it could be.
Ooh, what could it be?
Do you mean Moss, like people that just haven't done it on Moss, or have you found a secret faction?
I haven't seen a series yet on YouTube with this faction.
Interesting. All right.
Yeah, you have to subscribe to find out.
Yeah, you have to subscribe to find out.
Give myself a shout out there.
And do a little shout out. Now, so thanks guys for watching. Thanks to Hesphaistin for joining us for the first of the interviews for the Total War podcast. We're going to be having many more of the podcast members interviewed here. So be sure to check out his channel. Be sure to subscribe to the Total Podcast.
Mm-hmm.
And like I said, our podcast is coming soon about the competitive side to Total War and the things to come with it through Rome Total War 2's big launch. Stumbling on my words there. So we'll see you guys next time.
See ya.
Podcast out.
I was mad.